Germany supports affordable housing project in Ukraine. Germany, a Shining World Leadership Award for Compassion and a Shining World Caring Leadership Award laureate, donated 22.1 million euros towards the construction and renovation of safe housing for more than 1,500 people in the conflict-affected eastern region of Ukraine. The five-year initiative will be carried out by the International Organization for Migration and the government of Ukraine, with the housing located in two large towns. 500 families will be sheltered, 80% of whom will be internally displaced persons, while the remainder are original inhabitants of the area. The energy-efficient and eco-friendly accommodations will also have rent at affordable prices for its beneficiaries. Our appreciation, Germany and International Organization for Migration, for your humanitarian aid. May all those in need find stability and happiness in heaven's mercy.
Qatar Airways uses ultraviolet or UV technology to disinfect aircraft. Qatar Airways has become the first global carrier to use the chemical-free Honeywell UV cabin system to sanitize interior aircraft surfaces, cabins, and seats. The portable device is the size of a beverage cart, features extendable arms, and is clinically proven to effectively inactivate various viruses and bacteria. Along with the airline's continued sanitation of onboard linens and headrests, it will be used as an extra step beyond normal standards recommended by the International Air Transport Association and the World Health Organization. Qatar Airways currently has 6 units of the system and is working to secure additional models to use on all aircraft at Qatar's main international airport. We applaud your caring and diligent efforts, Qatar Airways, and pray for the safety of all the world's airline employees and passengers. In Allah's grace.
Solar panel system delivers clean drinking water to Native Americans in southwestern United States. Through an initiative by Zero Mass Water, a U.S.-based company which provides drinking water access via renewable resources, 15 homes in the Navajo Nation have been outfitted with solar panels that extract water from air. These Navajo families, like many others in their community, previously had to drive to the nearest town to buy water for all their needs. Now, the patented hydro panels will bring tap water into their homes. Each pair of panels lasts 15 years and produces 4 to 10 liters of water daily, plus stores 60 liters for cloudy days. The project was funded by Barclays Bank and Unreasonable Group, a private, socially conscious funding firm. Such an amazing technology, Zero Mass Water. Our gratitude to all involved in this laudable collaboration. May the pure-hearted Navajo Nation flourish in the Great Spirit's benevolence.
Reforestation project begins in southern Togo. 200 seedlings of the medicinal mahujan tree, along with other native West African species, have been planted in southern Togo by volunteers and personnel from the country's Ministry of Environment, Sustainable Development, and Nature Protection. This operation is part of a greater initiative to restore 1.4 million hectares of deforested and degraded land in all prefectures by 2030. It has been calculated that as a result, the nation's greenhouse gas emissions could be reduced by 11%, with additional economic benefits. Bravo, Togo, for undertaking this vast and crucial environmental endeavor. May the divine bless your beautiful country and citizens.
Indian real estate developer allows people in need to live in apartments rent-free. Indian real estate developer Prakash Balani, chairman of Rudraksh Developers, has provided accommodations for 42 families in newly built apartments owned by the company. After completing the construction of the building in Umrah, Madhya Pradesh state, during the COVID-19 pandemic, the flats could not be sold. Mr. Balani then decided to allow people who were financially affected by the pandemic to live in them. Each family pays $20 per month for electricity, security, cleaning and maintenance, and is allowed to stay as long as needed. The building's 50 remaining apartments will also be given to people in need. Our gratitude, Prakash Balani and Rudraksh developers, for your loving neighborly action. May heaven protect you and the gentle people of India, especially during these uncertain times.
Vegan fashion brand launches new faux cashmere line. Vegan fashion label Aparise, based in New York, United States, and founded by two French women, Amélie Brick and Lauren Nucci, recently launched a vegan cashmere collection that includes a range of cardigans, sweaters, and sweater dresses in the company's signature rainbow colors. Made from the plant-based material called viscose, plus polyester and polyamide, the incredibly soft material is chemical-free and easy to wash. Aparise plans to donate 5% of the collection's proceeds to the global animal rights nonprofit People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals, or PETA. Originally known for their faux fur coats, Aparise is now being sold in more than 500 stores in the U.S. and in another 20 countries. We welcome the launch of your new product line, Aparise, in divine guidance. May all clothing companies also recognize that compassionate animal-free apparel is the way to go.
British couple provides care for small animals in home-based rescue center. Since starting the Farm Animal Rescue nonprofit 4 years ago, 33-year-old social worker Nikki Palmer and his partner Robin Long have rescued and rehabilitated approximately 100 wild and domesticated animals from their home in the United Kingdom town of Harwich, Essex County. The animal-loving duo currently shares their house with 25 guests, including a cat and a dog, a tortoise, ducks, rabbits, guinea pigs, and a variety of birds. They have had many success stories of nurturing injured or orphaned animals and releasing or rehoming them accordingly. Speaking of their plans, the kind-hearted couple said, "We hope to carry on helping the animals in need for years to come." Our heartfelt thankfulness, Nikki Palmer and Robin Long. May we all be guardians of God's diverse creations in heaven's abiding care.